Be listening to B86 Radio this afternoon from 5 to 5:30 for a special program with Andy Jarrell and the folks from Lawnmower Racing. They'll be discussing what's happening in lawnmower racing today. The program is brought to you by Custom Frame Crafters, Steve Barnes Garage, Lisa's Fresh Fruits and Vegetables, Country Town Tire, and Mexico Viejo Restaurant.
B86 Morning Trading Post is heard Monday through Friday at 8:15. Join us for the B86 Morning Trading Post with Pete and George. Have a great day, and thanks for listening to the Trading Post.
Be listening to B86 Radio this afternoon from 5 to 5:30 for a special program with Andy Jarrell and the folks from Lawnmower Racing. They'll be discussing what's happening in lawnmower racing today. The program is brought to you by Custom Frame Crafters, Steve Barnes Garage, Lisa's Fresh Fruits and Vegetables, Country Town Tire, and Mexico Viejo Restaurant. Steve Barnes Garage and Body Shop has been serving Alexander County since 1973. Yes, that's right, 37 years of full-service garage, body, and frame shop work. They service all makes and models from Volkswagens to Peterbilt trucks. They also specialize in all makes and models of industrial and farm equipment. And don't forget about their 24-hour towing. Nothing is too large or small for their towing service. Steve Barnes Garage and Body Shop, service you can count on, quality you can trust, since 1973. Give the guys at Steve Barnes Garage and Body Shop a call today at 632-7446. They're located at 1735 Rocky Springs Road. Custom Frame Crafters does all types of framing, enlargements, reprints, old photo restoration, awards, trophies, plaques, engraving, signs, banners, storefront and vehicle lettering, graphics, and yard and magnetic signs. Custom Frame Crafters is open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5, located on Highway 16 south of Taylorsville. Give them a call today at 635-0444. Visit Mexico Viejo, Alexander County's original Mexican restaurant. Come enjoy healthy meals and courteous hometown service. We offer lunch specials, entrees, desserts, and also kids' meals. We even have authentic traditional Mexican specialty foods, proudly serving Alexander County since 2005. You can visit Mexico Viejo on Highway 90 East in Taylorsville, across from the gas house.
It's time now for Hollyview Motorsports Update. Go ahead, Andy.
Andy Jarrell here, driver to number 32, yellow.
Lee Moose, driver number 77.
Hunter Matlock, John Deere.
Number 70.
Number 70.
And the kid stock, right, Hunter?
Yeah.
Have you got the John Deere tuned up, ready to go for this race tomorrow?
Yeah.
Now, the race is tomorrow night, Tales of Lions Club Fairgrounds, 6 p.m., guys. Got to get out there, man. I tell you, we had some great racing. We're going to be covering our race, which was on Friday, July the 2nd, which was a special event, the Fallen Officers Memorial Race, and it, where 100% of proceeds went to benefit the Caisson unit. So, this is the race we'll be covering, and anybody that knows anything about the Caisson unit knows that they're non-profit. They're not state-funded, so any of the donations and everything has to come from the community and the surrounding areas, and
they're kept right here in Alexander County, down here in Hidden.
That's right. Based right here in Alexander County. And you know, something interesting I learned about it is that there's, you know, not Caisson units are not everywhere. I mean, there's hardly any of them even in the United States. So
there's three in the United States.
That's right.
One of them's here in North Carolina.
Right here in Alexander County. It's hard to believe in it. And you know, the folks that got to come out, which we had a great crowd, got to actually see the Caisson horses, and they're impressive to see in person for sure.
They are huge.
They are huge horses, and well maintained. I mean, they got good owners, and man, I'll tell you, it's you know, learned that Chevron was in Reagan's funeral, and where they traveled to was just it just incredible, you know. So,
can you mount one on the lawnmower?
They got more horsepower than we got, Bill, that's for sure. I mean, they got some torque, I know. As big as they are, I tell you, you put a handful of them together, you go somewhere. So, I tell you, man. And, you know, had a lot of involvement from the North Carolina Highway Patrol, and it was a great, great benefit for us all. And I'm glad that we could do it and raise a good amount of funds for the Caisson unit. So, and get on to the racing action.
That right, Hunter?
Hunter was in our first race for the evening. Kid Stock. And Kid Stock is stock mowing lawnmowers, take the blades off and install a, you know, tailored kill switch, mainly like what's on Sea-Doo's, and go racing, right, Hunter?
Yeah.
We had Andrew Jones, William Harris, Hunter Matlock, Brett Johnson, Jessica Moose, Grant Tudrow, Emily Shoemate, Trent Walker, and a new driver, Kerry Hicks, who done an outstanding job in the number 21. And all the, in the kids' stock, they all received the same medallion as winners, so they're all winners. And just ride around and have fun. It's fun in there, Hunter.
Yeah.
Hunter was running good, and he had a little issue with the carburetor on yours, didn't you, Hunter? Kind of started flooding out, didn't it?
Yeah.
Did you get that fixed? Get that remedy? Good deal. You ready to go tomorrow?
Yeah.
Got the John Deere ready, D. Good deal, Hunter. So then we'll move to modified stock. Finishing first was Justin Billings. Second was John Johnson. That's a close race with Justin just edging him out ever so slightly for the victory. So, I mean, they're getting, you know, the race is getting tighter and tighter.
They too like switching the leader.
They do, I tell you. Seems like every, you know, it's however it falls, you know, who's going to win the race. So, they put on an outstanding show there. Then we move to the super modified open V-twin, 38-44 cubic inch, where, surprise, surprise, the winner was Kevin Shoemate. Once again, Scott Billings finishing second, and myself, Andy Gerald finishing third. So I got to give him a big hand for, hey, that's a great group of guys to race with there, and we really try to, you know, put on a good show. So.
The main thing is crossing the finish line of whether you're first or last.
Exactly. On your wheels, Billy.
On the wheels.
You know, on the wheels. So I tell you, you know, we put on a great lot of action. You know, Billy had a lot of action.
Oh, yeah.
So I tell you, we sure sling the dirt and have a lot of fun. Then we moved to stock single cylinder overhead valve, where Lee Moose led a good portion of this event.
Yeah, there's a fair bit of it.
You led a good portion of it. It's good to see the number 77 back in the lead. That's where we've traditionally been seeing it, Lee, and you look like you hammered down.
Well, it's kind of hard to get in front of him when he's slapping mud on your face here.
Yeah.
But Lee had the lead till Chris Johnson. Done a bump and run there.
Yeah, that he did, twice.
So we had Chris Johnson winning, Tyler Jones second, and Lee Moose finishing third in that. So I tell you, Lee, put on a good show, good run there. But Chris Johnson, he's really hot. He's on the money now. So
yeah, his days are numbered.
I know. Well, you know. I think Lee might have a little surprise for him this weekend. We'll see though. He looks like he's got a little something.
I thought about it.
That should get thing good for him one day, Lee. I tell you. Oh, man, what a great time we have. Modified single-cylinder overhead valve, we had James Seddon win it, with Robert Billings finishing second and Harold Henning fourth finishing third. And I tell you, James really had his machine rolling this weekend, didn't he?
Yeah, he did this time. James, he led it.
He led it. Well, I mean, he had everything right, and he rolled with it from the very start to the end. And, I mean, whenever you outrun Robert Billings, I mean, you've done your day's work, and he, you know, Robert was looking at him, but I tell you, James was just hammered down, wasn't he?
That he was.
So, then we moved to Powder Puff, which is ladies only guy. So, Powder Puff, we had Carolyn Medley in the number 40 winning. Melissa Billings and her new hot rod for this year in the number 3 finishing second, and Lisa Jones in the John Deere rounding out the top 3 in the number 70. So that was a good race there with that. And we move to the Legends. Isn't that right, Hunter? Legends.
What is Legends, Hunter?
Old folks.
Old folks. Would I be considered an old folks?